Oh, it's Wednesday, October the 24th, 2018. And what a great day as we're talking about the final episode from 1 Thessalonians 5. Listen to these first 11 verses. But concerning the times and the seasons, brethren, you have no need that I should write you. For you yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so comes as a thief in the night. For when they say, peace and safety, then sudden destruction comes upon them as labor pains upon a pregnant woman, and they shall not escape. But you, brethren, are not in the darkness, so that this day should overtake you as a thief. You're all sons of light, sons of the day. We're not of the night, nor of the darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as others do, but let us watch and be sober. For those who sleep, sleep at night, and those who are drunk, get drunk at night. But let us who are of the day be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and as a helmet, the hope of salvation. For God did not appoint us to wrath, but to obtain salvation through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died for us, that whether we wake or sleep, we should live together with him. Therefore, comfort each other and edify one another, just as you also are doing. Okay, we're in scene three. The 1 Thessalonians 5 of this last episode, the final chapter before the great escape. And scene three concentrates on verses 6 and 8. Verse 6 says, let us not sleep as others do, but let us watch and be sober. And verse 8 says, but let us who are of the day, in other words, sons of the light, let us be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and as a helmet, the hope of salvation. So we have clear instruction here in scene three, how we're to be as we're in anticipation of the Lord's return. Even though he's coming as a thief in the night, he'll not come as a thief to us. He won't overtake us as a thief because we are living in this kind of mode. We are sober. We are watching. We are alert. We're looking at the signs of the time. We're watching the events of the end time around us. We're seeing the increase of evil. We're watching the falling away of those who proclaim to know Jesus. They are dissipating into darkness. They refuse to walk in holiness. They don't want the light of the day. They've got secret places. They've got closets where they're practicing evil deeds, and they're kind of lurking in the darkness, like themselves being thieves. And the enemy's robbing them of the joy of the Lord as their strength. It's robbing them of the hope of eternal life in them. We're not like that. We're watching and we're sober. And then I love this. We have the breastplate of faith and love. Now, last week we talked about love all week long. And love is a trademark. It's the stamp of believers and followers of Jesus Christ. And we're supposed to let love have its perfect work in us. We're supposed to love our enemies and do good to them that despitefully use us. But we've got our breastplate. This is where our heart's at. See, it's out of the heart that everything proceeds. Issues of life, all the issues come out of our heart. If our heart is in anticipation in this final episode before the Lord returns, if our heart's in anticipation of it, we're going to have our heart covered by something in the breastplate of faith and love. Faith is this trust that God's word is true. He's going to keep his promise. He's coming back. And then we have for a helmet, got our mind covered. Oh, wow. Do we need our mind protected from all the fiery darts of the enemy where he shoots these thoughts into our head? We've got to have our mind protected. And we're protected by the hope of the glorious appearing of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. That hope, we've got to stir it up. We've got to keep thinking about it. We've got to keep being in anticipation. He's coming back. And he promised us that we would be eternally safe. It would be eternally guarded. We'd spend eternity living together with him. And so in scene three of the final episode, here's what's happening. We are sober and watching. We're alert to what's happening in our culture, in our world at large, and we're sober. We're thinking about it. We're keeping our mind on alert. We're not frivolous. We're not flying around flitty and just being a jerk or being careless about life. We're sober. And we've got the breastplate of faith and love. We've got the helmet, the hope of salvation. And so our anticipation is growing. And we say with John the Revelator, even so, come quickly, Lord Jesus. Oh, Lord, I pray for encouragement today for every follower of Christ, that they gird up their loins and they make sure that faith is guarding their heart and love is guarding their heart. They make sure their mind is being guarded by the helmet of hope of salvation. Oh, Holy Spirit, help us today. Pray discouragement to be dispelled because we are looking into the glorious gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And so, Lord, let us be strong in you in the power of your might today as we live in constant anticipation of your return. Amen. Oh, be filled with joy today. Lord's coming back. In the meantime, you're guarding your heart with faith and love, and you're guarding your mind with the helmet of the hope of salvation. Be blessed. You are. Have a great day.